welcome back to Arkansas Bigfoot. You know, sometimes you just have to ask yourself, how far are you really willing to go to find something that you probably really don't want to find? If you've seen and experienced the things that we have seen in the past 16 hours, you probably wouldn't be out here where we're at right now. There's things that have happened that maybe at a future date I'll share a little bit of it with you, but it is beyond description and beyond explanation. We can hear the footsteps in the woods around us, and we've seen the eyes shine when we first got down in here. We are back at the last gifting tree, and we had came back earlier in the day to check on those Oregon blocks, and every one of them are gone from the trees that we had placed them at. And the nest structure had all of this new build on it, all the way up, 14 foot tall logs. This is after we found the giant footprints back again that we believe belonged to Big Daddy, or Twinkle Toes as I affectionately call him. Behind the nest, there was a stack of three rocks left on this stump. All of the wood was torn off and leveled the stump so they could stack the rocks on it. Inside the nest, we had put that plastic pan that had the sand and the drink and some little toys and other stuff in it, and the plastic tote disappeared, as well as several of the items that were in it. What we found was the drink bottle, the little red flower, and the little yellow spongy, like a play toy. After a little further investigation, something caught my eye down the trail, back at the main trail that they used to cross into Skunk Island. And I'll try to get here where you can see it through the trees. I've got a light down here on the ground. But a good 12 foot up on a tree that's freshly broken, 12 foot tall in the air, is the white tote. The tree is snapped off, the tote is placed on top, and at the bottom is a new glyph that we found. And that's every bit of 12 foot. Rachel's approximately 5'9" with her boots on, and it's twice her height. There's other things that have happened and that we've seen and that we actually even got on recording that maybe at another time when I feel comfortable with it, I'll let some of it out, but honestly, I'm not ready for it, and I don't believe a lot of other people are ready for it either. A that I definitely did not want to leave everybody hanging, wondering what had happened to those blocks that we put out. And that tree there snapped off at about 10 foot. Like I said, I think the big guy's back in town. That's taller than I can reach.
There's no limb below it either.
And the limb that came off of it has been thrown onto the structure over here. But we've caught eyeshine tonight, and we've heard the footsteps walking around in the woods. I doubt that they'll come any closer, knowing that the camera and that the light is on. I'm going to turn off the light for a little while. I'll leave the camera running for a few minutes and maybe we'll catch some kind of audio. I don't know. Guys, the lights are going out. If it weren't for the road noise, they could hear it too. Something just moved in the water up here on my left. I just heard a grunt. is, I think you get the picture of what we're going through down here. I'm gonna end the video here and we will catch you on the next run. Good night.